The sun always rises.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Rare here, and today we're playing some Jungle Arcade Hecarim. Aw, yeah. Now, I'm gonna wait for it, because I know she's gonna interrupt me. See, there it is, so not my problem anymore. Do I just want to ignore? Nope, okay, we're good. Alright, so, we're gonna be playing Jungle Hecarim, and just to show how much I love you guys, Skyward Sword is on right now, with Summer Games Done Quick, and I'm doing this instead of watching that. And if that is not proof that I am dedicated to this channel, I don't know what is, because that run is looking really awesome right now. Anyway, Arcade Hecarim, the Rainbow Super Pony. He's got a pretty cool voice, pretty cool laugh, and pretty cool skin. So it looks like they're maybe gonna take my red? Maybe? I guess I'll find out. The one big mistake I did make, and this is a very big mistake, and I apologize for this, is that I took Flash instead of Ghost. I got my rune page on, and then I went like semi-FK for a little bit. I totally forgot to swap it, so that's on me. Ghost is way better on Hecarim than Flash, so that might hurt us a little bit, but it's okay. Anyway, Hecarim's passive, and why Ghost is much better, is Warpath. Hecarim can move through units, and you gain attack damage equal to 10% of your bonus move speed. So, TLDR, faster you move, the more damage you do, which is nice. So we're just gonna bully Caitlyn out of here. 8% more experience from that there zillion. Aw, snaps. I'm gonna go to my red, actually. If they're taking it. Fine. Alright, I'm gonna do my blue. Never mind, I lied. I lied. Alright, let's spam the Q here. Not the best opener, but not the worst. For a second, I thought I smited the little creep, and I was freaking out, but we're good. We're good. Alright, so, looks like the leader's going to be stealing my red. I mean, if we're going to go, we're going to have to go now. Oh, I'm coming! I'm coming! Sup, Udyr? Sup, Udyr? Oh, well, we forced him to use all of his summoners. That's good. So he can't really take my red now. Unfortunately, Malphite's going to be behind in lane, but that's really helpful for me to where Udyr can't bully me. And that's pretty huge. So go ahead and pop the health potion here. I'm not too worried about Udyr getting a steal, but I should just be aware of it at least. Okay, nope, we got our red, no problem. That's awesome. That's really awesome, actually. Huge start for us. Udyr blew pretty much all of his summoners, I think. And we got away scot-free, because Hecarim's pretty weak early, so not having to deal with Udyr's BS is a very comforting thought. And I apologize if it sounds like I'm mashing my keyboard, it's because I am. Q is on such a low cooldown, I tend to mash it when I play Hecarim, just out of habit. Kind of get the APM up a little bit as well. It's nothing major, but it's just a small something I do. Okay, let's see. Well, she's level 2, and she does have armor 5, so you know what? See if I can make something happen here. Alright, nope, nothing really. That's fine. I still have both my buffs, so it's really not a big deal if I take a couple seconds just to kind of harass Riven a little bit. You know, it pops a potion, that's about it, but that's okay. Hopefully Malzahar will be okay in mid here. I mean, I'd imagine so, but you never know. Go ahead and pop the smite here while I have W up. I think that still works, where Smite will heal me. Let's see, because Hecarim is healed for 20% damage done. Yeah, yeah, from any source. So Smite heals you if you have your W up. I figured that was the case, but for some reason, part of me was thinking, is that still how that works? But it is, so all is well. I do like the effects on Arcade Hecarim, especially the guitar. It's pretty awesome, not gonna lie. This is actually my first time playing him. I got the skin from a friend who went to PAX. And he was like, hey, do you want this skin? I have a couple extra copies. I was like, heck yeah, dude. So now I have PAX Jax and Arcade Hecarim, which is very cool. So we'll go ahead and just clear out this white here. Don't have my blue buff anymore, so I have to be a little bit aware of that at least. It's not a huge deal, but, you know, it's just something to pay attention to. So, the big Iron Man. Also a resident of the Shadow Isles. But seems like he's not available right now, so I'm just going to head back here. That electricity and guitar solo back with Rambos, too. Dang, this skin's cool, man. Alright, so Spirit Stone, Boots. And we'll get A Ward as well. Go ahead and pop the E just to get back a little faster. Rainbow Pony, activate! Super fast, super speed. Looks like Udyr went for a gank bot lane. Wasn't successful, though. Draven got the first blood, which is fantastic. Malphite seems to be doing not great top, not terrible. He's 20 CS behind, that's a little bad. But at the same time, he also helped me out early. So it's partially my fault, like I'm partially responsible for the fact that he's doing poorly. I'm just going to clear out this ward, actually. Boop, there you go. Now he doesn't have vision, so if I want to harass him later, I can. I probably won't, being honest, but I certainly could. I'm actually going to run back over to the south jungle because I know that soon my blue buff's going to be up. So I will show myself, and that kind of delays it. Ooh, bot lane's in trouble here. Yeah, that's bad. Malzahar messed up there. Pinged it too late. That's unfortunate. Well, I should probably come bot and help. Especially if they're gonna shove. But, there's really not all that much I can do to stop them, unfortunately. Oh, he's just going straight forward, isn't he? Alright, let's see if I can get there in time to help out. Alright, come here, you. Nice. Good job, Mels. That was a solid pickup right there. At the very least, it helps out. Also, I'll just go ahead and take blue here. Much rather you get that. Oh, he's dead. Okay, I need to know where they're at, because if they're under tower, that's not that bad. But will he okay, he actually trades one for one. That's not terrible. Go ahead and pop the E here. So we have six now. So we can actually gank much more effectively. How low is Mord? That's risky. He's got health potions, and he might do damage. That's pretty risky. We'll just go back. So we're actually going to build this into Ninja Tabi. We're not going to go for Mobis, because that's pretty greedy on Hecarim, and I'm going to be playing Hecarim fairly tanky. So next thing we're going to get is Spirit of the Ancient Golem for the conservation stacks. I will be ganking mid, A, because Mord's low and didn't back, and B, because I have blue, so it's kind of partially my responsibility to gank mid. Or at the very least, try and make a play. Go ahead and put down a pink here. Now, he doesn't have any wards because I killed them before. Oh. Good job, Draven. We can dragon off that. We can absolutely dragon off that. So, good job to Jana and Draven. Definitely some nice pressure for us there. Thank you for the shield, I appreciate that. I should put a quick sweeper down here just to double check, but it looks good. Not too concerned. I wish Draven would come, that would be nice, but Malzahar came over, so we'll be fine. How much this might do? 500... now. Would have been nice if we had Draven, because then I wouldn't have taken as much damage, and I probably could have ganked more effectively, but it's not the end of the world. Well, he put the ult on me, so unfortunately we also stacked ults, that was kind of my fault, but it's fine. He wasted Children of the Grave, so I'm not dead. That's perfectly fine. So I'm actually going to put a ward right here. I'm not going to do my red just yet, because it's a little risky. Going to wait for the fight. There we go. Oh, is he going to swing over? Yeah, he might. Yep. Oh, yeah. He went for the swing. Quite literally. I mean, I want to engage on this, but I also kind of don't want to engage on this. But I want to. Yeah, it's just not worth it. And that's why. I figured Udyr would be around, so I'm glad I have that ward down, because it gives us absolute control over vision of where Udyr can come from. Like, there's no attack path I won't see, so I'm not going to get, you know, caught out by him here. Now, I know he's coming, so I got to peace out. Alright, here we go. Nope. Oh, what? What killed me there? Ignite's gonna kill Malphite. What got the final blow? Oh, Tiger Stance. Oh, Tiger Stance. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm not gonna lie, that's unfortunate, but it happens, so 1-1-1. Not the best, not the worst. It is what it is. Still no Spirit of Ancient Gold. Not quite yet. Don't have enough money. But Draven's really far ahead, which is awesome. So he's about to be even more far ahead, because I'm assuming he's going to probably kill Caitlyn here. Yep. He got the zillion ult off, so he'll pick up the kill, I'm sure. Good job, Malzahar mid. Draven will pick up a kill bot and probably escape. I'm going to speed up and see if I can get there in time. I'm actually going to gank him at his... and his golems here. Oh yeah. No, I'm gonna gank Swan. YOLO. YOLO! Oh well, we got the tower. That's fine. I'm not gonna take the CS from Draven, because that'd be kind of a, you know, dickish move. Yeah, it's true. That's definitely true. What I just typed out is really the critical part, is that we gave Riven double buff. Yeah. It's my fault. Because, I died, and then Malphite killed Udyr, who had my buffs, and then Riven killed Malphite, so she got, you know, basically it was a huge buff transfer, and I should have recognized that and made top lane my priority, but I didn't, so that is my mistake. One thing I do want to discuss, actually, is if you guys haven't already, you should totally read up on the patch notes coming out, because the new Spirit of the Ancient Golem is super awesome. It gives you 25% bonus health. It's basically like, it gives you health back and mana back when you kill jungle minions, which is kind of cool, or jungle camps, rather. And it gives you armor, cooldown reduction, like, it's just a pretty kick-ass item now. And it's going to bring back a lot of tank jungles into the game. Like, I can see Nautilus again, I can see Zac again. We'll see a lot more diversity than just carry junglers. And if you play Hecarim tanky, like I am, instead of going for, you know, Elder Lizard, then there's, I don't know, man, it's good. It's just a really good item. So Udyr's coming in here. See if I can pick up, yeah, okay, I can easily pick up that kill. That's not a problem. Get the fear there. And there's a kill for Draven. I didn't even want to take it. I just wanted to make sure he got it, so. Just throw off the quick Q there. And we can do a lot of damage to his tower, so. Getting bombed by Draven. I know Riven's coming around, which is fine. Let Malzahar know he can have his blue. And it looks like they're gonna head back bot. Apparently he doesn't want it, which is fine with me. I'll just go ahead and take it. Alright, Malz. Well, thanks, man. Are you building mana? No, I mean, you got Rite of Ages. Not a lot of mana regen, but if he doesn't want it, that's fine. It helps me out a lot. So, I appreciate it, man. Alright. Oh, Malphite was like, oh, I'm sorry, Malphite. I didn't mean to troll you there. But no, I was not referring to you, but also I just queued nothing like a boss. But that's okay. Pop the E here for the bonus damage. Ba-boom. And we'll just wait for it. There we go, spam Q. The lovely part about Hecarim's W is that it makes it really, really, really easy to sustain yourself, both in the jungle and also later in the game during teamfights. It'll make it really, really easy for me to sustain myself if I build tank, because I'm probably going to pick up Spirit Visage. Maybe. Not right away. But at some point, I may very well pick it up. Well, I'd like to personally try and do Dragon here. So, there's no ward. Go ahead and just slow pick it up. There is an Udyr though. I'm gonna go ahead and peel. Got the Q off. Nice ult from Janna as well. And there's the ult from the announcer Draven. Good job, Draven. Nice work, man. And might as well pick up the kill on Riven. Nice job, team. We might lose mid tower, but that's not that big of a deal. But if I speed, I might actually be able to get there in time. At the very least, I can punish him. Yeah, he knows. He knows he's either totally screwed or about to be. Got the fear and the slow. There's the Janna nato. That was a nice nato by Janna too. Just die. Just die. Holy crap, just die. Okay. Jeez. Don't want to die to red buff. I probably could kill it because I have W, but I'm just going to go back. It's not even worth the risk. Goodness gracious, that ward just did not want to die. Nice sustain on his part. That rock and guitar solo. Alright, so I want to get Chili Mittens on the one and only Hecarim. We're going to lose Draven, unfortunately, bot lane. That's okay, though. That's going to be a kill from Alzahar for sure. Possibly even a double, honestly. My red might be gone here. We'll see. It might have been worth it for Caitlyn. She got the shutdown gold on Draven, so yeah. The one for one is probably worth it. So, no ward here, so I'm pretty much clear to do my red, which is what I'm going to do. And we'll just keep on hacking slashing. Alright, got the red buff. Riven's missing right now. Should probably try and find her. At some point or another, anyway. Just having vision on her would be good. Looks like Mordekaiser's actually rotating over. Is Udyr here? I'm not sure, but Mordekaiser caught himself out, so I'll just take the free kill, honestly. There's Riven. Well, nice ult from Malz. Good ult from Draven as well, obviously. Nice. Another kill for Draven. That's huge. I'd much rather donate them all to him. I have no problems doing that at all. So, go ahead and pop a W. Do damages. Alright, let's get this tower down. Should be pretty straightforward with two of them dead. Now, the one thing I will say is Draven did rush Bloodthirster, and I really just don't think that's worth doing anymore. He might have got Ghostblade first, and Ghostblade isn't terrible now. It's actually pretty decent, but Bloodthirster is just not an item you should rush anymore. Like, even with the upgrade coming out in the next patch, where it's going to give you a 10% flat bonus ability power, or bonus attack damage, rather, it's just still not worth it. It's really not. Did I get that fear or did I miss it? I can't tell. I thought I got it. Jesus, come on. Whatever. I'll flash for it. It's fine. That's worth it to me. I'm coming. I'm coming, buddy. Nice ult there from Malz. Nope. Get slowed. Alright, well, Malz is going to try and kill me here. But I'm just going to back off so that way he can't. I'll be perfectly fine. Draven can pick up that kill. I'm not worried about that. Yeah, and also get the assist. So that's perfectly fine. It wasn't worth risking myself to needlessly die. That would just be stupid. So we'll go back here, get Chili Mittens. Which is really, 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 really good on Hecarim. It just makes it so easy to catch people. And to keep them... that was the wrong button, but whatever. And to just keep them within not only your W, but also your just constant Qs. So... that'll help out our team a lot. It also makes me a bit more tanky. I'm actually 4-1-5. Nice. Solid game in Arcane Hecarim so far. Pretty happy with that. Haven't played him in quite a while. He's a very fun champion. And next, if I get the money, I'll go for Sunfire. just for more tank against Riven and Caitlyn Udyr. If I don't get the money, maybe not Sunfire. I might go for like, well, I don't know. I really want Sunfire and Hecarim because it's really good. It synergizes with your W. It's armor. It gives you more health. Like, it's just a good item in general. But I guess we'll just see what I need to buy depending. Because I don't really feel the need to rush any magic resistance right now, like Spirit Passage, just because Mordekaiser honestly just isn't that big at the moment. It doesn't really warrant it. Good job to Mels again. Go ahead and pick up that melee there. So, team's engaging, it seems like. Draven's doing oh my god, so much damage. Ridiculous. I'm actually going to speed my way over here. Might not necessarily fight, but we can easily just zone them. And even push on this tower, quite honestly. Nice block by Draven there with his Bloodthirster shield. That was cute. I like that. So I've got to wait for a minion wave real quick. I'll put my ward over the wall, actually. Just for some more vision. Slowly get this tower down here. Oh wow, we just completely destroyed that Udyr. The fast ult by Zillion, otherwise he would have just been straight up dead. Still, that means Zillion ult's on cooldown now. That's great. Just gotta wait on some minions again real quick. But, I mean, honestly, at this point, we're in a pretty good spot. I'm just gonna hit the tower here. Oh, that's one tower down. We know Zillion ult's on cooldown. Riven's almost dead. Good job to Draven. Or not Draven, Darius. Or what? No, yes, it is Draven. What am I saying? I always get those two confused for no apparent reason. We have a Draven on our team, not a Darius. They're brothers. That's why I get them confused. Goodness. It's in the lore. Ladies and gentlemen, it's in the lore. Oh, wow. GG. Okay, well, 22-minute game. Thank you. Thank you, Mouse. I didn't want to die. Well, yeah, that went really well. The only lane that really had trouble was top lane Malphite, just because Riven is strong. But, I mean, dang, man, we got plenty of kills. Good team fight. We got every dragon. Malphite helped me early to protect me from Udyr ganking my red, which was, like, huge, because then I had no pressure in jungle. I could just do whatever I wanted. And, yeah, solid game by the team there. Sorry we didn't get a chance to ramp up. We got Chili Mittens, which was what I wanted to rush, but I didn't get a chance to go Sunfire or Randwinds or Spirit Visage or anything, because we just won. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. Peace out.